अस्सलामु अलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। यस माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 7, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेसन नंबर 3 ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 1। द नेम ऑफ दिस लेसन इज इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ तौहीद एंड इट्स अफेक्ट ऑन ह्यूमन लाइव्स। इफ़ यू रिमेंबर, इन आवर फर्स्ट टू लेसन्स वी हैव जस्ट लर्न अबाउट व्हाट आर द मीनिंग ऑफ तौहीद एंड व्हाट आर इट्स एस्पेक्ट्स, एंड वी केम टू नो दैट there are 3 aspects of tawheed and there are 7 conditions of tawheed, and when we have the clear concept of tawheed, we have the deep faith in tawheed in our heart, then there are different effects of this on our life. So what are the effects of believing in tawheed? We will see in this lesson. Let's start the lesson. We're told here that a Muslim must believe in tawheed, mean oneness of Allah, and act according and to the spirit of tawheed. He must first cleanse his heart of any other gods or objects of worship. Only then will tawheed take root in his heart. So what's the first condition if we want to root tawheed in our heart? So what's first demand? We have to clean our heart. It's clear, it's, you can see the example here to make the concept clear. They are given us one example. And what is the example? Suppose we have a piece of land full of weeds and thorns where we want to produce wheat. Now, if we sow seeds of wheat in the land without first cleaning it, we can't expect to get a crop out of the weeds and thorns. So what do we do now? We must cultivate the land, clear the weeds and bushes, and prepare the soil before we plant the wheat. Then we can expect a good crop. So very easy and simple example is given to us to understand the concept. If we have a land, if we have the piece of land, suppose in front of your house you have a piece of land for the garden, you want to grow there some beautiful flowers or something useful, but there are many weeds and many bushes in that place. So what will you do first? Can you get the beautiful flowers there? No, you have to do something first. And what is the first thing? You have to clean that place for the cultivation of any other useful thing. So in the same way, when we want to plant the concept of tawheed, the belief of tawheed in our heart, first we have to clean the land of our heart from all other false beliefs, from all other false god. We have to clean our heart and we have to cultivate then only the love of Allah in our heart, and then it can grow properly. So let's see in the second paragraph. Let's compare the land with our hearts. In it, the heart is full of the belief in false gods. We can't expect tawheed to take root within it. So we must clean the heart of all other gods and objects of worship. Then we do so. Then tawheed will take root in the heart and the light of faith will emanate from it. So it's mean that when we make our land of the heart clear from all other false beliefs, then the true faith, then the faith of tawheed will come out from our heart, from this land. Tawheed shapes and regulates the entire course of our life. That is why we must understand the meaning of tawheed and act according to its spirit and the principles. So when we believe in tawheed and our heart is clean from all other beliefs, then there is greater effect of this one on our life. So let's see what its effects on our life. Come on the next page, page number 2. There are given some effects of tawheed on human life. Number 1 is given here. Belief in tawheed and acting upon its principles has a far-reaching effects on human life. A mohit. Mohit means a person who believes in tawheed, surrenders himself completely to the will of Allah and become his true servant and subject. So Allah is pleased with him and he assures him of a perpetual happy life after death. So what is the first effect? And it is very important effect. When a person believes in Tawheed, now he becomes a true Muslim and he always follow the orders of Allah. He loves Allah and he says that Samayana wa Atana. He follows all the orders of Allah without any objection. And when he does this one, Allah Almighty get pleased with him. And what is the result? We will get Jannah, we will get a perpetual, never-ending happiness, even in this life also and the life after our death. As we know that being a Muslim, that the death is not the end of the life, it is just the starting of some other life. So if we want to get the happiness, permanent happiness of that life, so we should be obedient to Allah Almighty, we should follow the orders of Allah. In this way, we can get this reward. This is the first and foremost and very important effect of believing in Tawheed. Then number two is given to us. Tawheed produces for believers a high degree of self-respect and confidence. How it creates a self-respect and confidence? Just come to the next line. A mu'min can depend completely on Allah for all the fulfillment of his needs. He is certain that Allah alone has the ability to fulfill them and that none except Allah has the power to benefit him. It's also a very important point. When a Muslim believes in Allah Almighty, he has the deep faith that Allah Almighty can do each and everything. He is our Rabb, as we read in the previous lesson, that he is our Rabb. He can provide us each and everything. Nobody else can provide these things. So if we have the deep faith, then in any need, we just turn towards Allah. We just do the prayers towards Allah and we ask him for our needs. And surely he will grant our needs. He will not turn our duas, our prayers unfulfilled. So this is the result of our deep faith or in deep faith in Tawheed. And how this create or make the high degree of self-respect? Suppose if you don't believe in Allah Almighty and you just look here and there for the fulfillment of your needs, you ask this person and you ask those person for your needs. So you have the respect in their eyes? No, definitely they will just, it is the cause of the disgrace of your personality. If you feel that, What the respect of the beggars in your eyes? You don't respect them as you respect some other people. They lose their respect. Why? Because they are begging from the people. They are not begging from Allah Almighty. So when we ask for our needs to the other personalities, we will not have self-respect at that time. And even we don't have the confidence. And if we are asking Allah Almighty for all our needs, so we are not guilty of asking some other personalities. So we have a confidence. We can live our life quite confidently that we are not under any person. We are not asking any other person for our needs. Number three is Tawheed makes a believer dutiful and upright. He knows that he must carry out the commands of Allah to succeed in his life and the next. This awareness makes him responsible and keeps him from neglecting duties and committing sins. What is the third point? It is that our true believers, if he believe in Allah Almighty and he believe all his qualities and attributes, so he knows that Allah, in Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir also, and also he is alim. He knows each and everything. He can watch us. Even he can watch us when we are alone in our room. And nobody knows what we are doing. But Allah Almighty knows. If we do not performing our duties, he is watching us. And on the last day after our death, we are responsible. We have to give the answers for why we were not doing our duties. So when a person believes in Tawheed, he has the deep feeling that Allah is watching us. So he becomes dutiful, he becomes a rightful person, he tries to do all his duties. And what is the result of all that? At the end, in the other life, in the last day, he will be successful inshallah. Look on the next paragraph. Tawheed makes a believer content. He doesn't worry because he knows that Allah will provide for all his needs if he is truly obedient. This is another aspect that a believer, he knows that Inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadeer. He is his Rabb. He provides him each and every need. So he just pray to Allah for his needs. And if suppose he doesn't get that he wants in his life, so he become contented. He doesn't become much worried, always thinking about that thing and always just thinking that, oh, I don't have this one, because he has the confidence that Allah will not let me alone. So he is quite contented at that time, and he will be loved by Allah if he is a contented person. It makes a person brave and courageous. It removes from his mind the fear of death and concern for safety. The believer knows that whatever good or evil happens to him is by the will of Allah. So if he obeys Allah, he has nothing to worry about. He goes on doing his duties without any fear. This is another quality of believing in Tawheed, another benefit that if a person believes in Tawheed, he becomes courageous. He becomes powerful. He can do anything because he is not afraid of death. He knows that whenever the time of death, nobody can save him from dying. And if there is no time of death, so nobody can make him die. So he becomes very much brave. He can do all his duties and everything that the other people can't do. They are afraid of doing this one, but he is not afraid. He can do this one because he has the deep faith in Allah Almighty that he is protecting him. The most important effect of Tawheed is that it makes a person submissive and obedient to Allah's command. A Mawheed is sure that Allah knows and sees everything and that Allah is nearer to him than his own jugular vein. So a true believer is afraid to commit a sin either secretly or openly because of his knowledge that Allah observes everything all the time. So a believer believes that Allah is watchful. Allah is Alim. He knows each and everything. Even he knows if a leaf fell from the tree. If a leaf falls from the tree, Allah knows about it even. So whatever we are doing alone in our room, nobody is watching us. But if we have the belief in Allah, we know that Allah is watching me at that time. So we will not do that sin, we will not do that wrong deed, even we are alone in our room. So this belief can save us from committing all type of sins. And when we avoid the sins, definitely, inshallah, we will have the hope to enter Jannah. A Mawheed seeks Allah's pleasure by turning his belief into action. Belief without action has no value in Islam. Iman without action is unacceptable. And action without belief is meaningless. We as Muslims believe in Tawheed, so this faith with all its magnificent manifestation must be reflected in our actions. The life of a true Muslim is an expression of his belief and action. So at the last, a very important thing is told to us that being a Muslim, only saying that I am believing in only Allah Almighty, Allah is my Rabb, and I know that Allah is alone, the words are not enough. The Iman, the concept of Tawheed, it demands our actions also. If we are saying that I am a true Muslim, I believe in Allah, then by our action we have to prove this one. I am believing that Allah is my Rabb. I should worship only Allah Almighty. We should follow the orders of Allah Almighty. We should do the actions what we are told to do. So if we are just doing the action, we don't have the faith in Tawheed, so it is not enough also. So both things are necessary. The deep faith in Tawheed also by words and by heart, and to act upon that faith, to do the actions, both are necessary. If we do these two things, then we will be successful. So these are all the benefits of believing in Tawheed. So hope you understand.